Hi guys, Jen here with How Jen Does It. Today I'm going to be sharing lots of tips for how you can simply and inexpensively update your home. We have lived in this home for a little over 3 years, and I know a lot of you followed the journey as we purchased this home and did lots of renovations and updates. So I learned a lot of things along the way as far as how to save money on updates and also simple things that you can do that have a big impact. This is a collab with Hillary from Old World Home. I'm sure a lot of you are following Hillary, but if you aren't, you definitely need to check out her video and channel. Hillary and I started YouTube right around the same time, so I have been watching her for years. And they bought a home about a year ago, and they have been updating it. She recently did a sunroom update, and it is so cute and charming. She recently did it, so you'll be able to find that video as well. I know she is going to have tons of great tips to share because she is always doing new things to her home and she's able to do it without spending tons of money. So you'll definitely want to check out her video as well. If you are coming over from Hillary's channel, welcome. I am Jen and this is How Jen Does It. I have a variety of videos on my channel. I do a lot of home related videos, so I have cleaning routines and I do decorating. I love to cook, so I have a lot of recipes. I do a lot of different things on my channel, so it's quite a variety. So if you are just stopping by, I hope that you'll stick around and subscribe to my channel. Okay, let's get into all of the tips that I want to share with you today. My first tip is clean, and I'm not talking about just the basic cleaning your home and getting rid of clutter, although I do think that makes a huge difference in the overall look and feel of your home. But let's go a little deeper. One thing that you can clean is your carpet, and it will make a huge difference. So if you have a carpeted room or space, it takes up a lot of the room. And if it's dirty or it looks a little dingy, think about cleaning it. You can rent a carpet cleaner or even look into having it professionally cleaned, and it will make such a difference. Also, tile. You can make a huge difference in the way your bathrooms and kitchen, if you have tile in there, look by cleaning the tile. Before we moved into this home, there were a few rooms that we didn't rip out the flooring, and we had the tile in there professionally cleaned, and it made such a difference. I just recently scrubbed all of the grout in my master bathroom because we had the tile professionally cleaned, but it's been 3 years. It's the original tile, and it's just one thing that I could do to improve the look of the bathroom without spending any money, really. Another thing that you can clean that will make a big difference is light fixtures. So say you have a light fixture and you haven't cleaned it in a while, it can look really dim and dingy. Just giving it a good scrub will really make a difference. And a lot of times, if you're moving into a place, you just think, oh, I need to change all of the light fixtures or most of them. But think about the ones that you can clean. When we moved here, we had a light fixture above the kitchen island, and it was so dirty. It was like really greasy, and there was like ketchup or barbecue sauce or something that had like splattered on it. And I cleaned that thing like crazy, and now I really like it, and it's nice and clean, and I keep it clean. My next tip is paint, and I have lots of ideas here. Obviously, you can paint a room. A fresh coat of paint makes a huge difference. You can really lighten and brighten a space with a fresh coat of paint. When we bought this house, it was a dark beige color. I didn't like the color. I didn't like the way that color made the space feel. This home has lots of bright windows and it's a bright space, and then that dark color just wasn't doing it any favor, so we painted it a light gray. So any space can really be updated with paint. You can paint your cabinets, so kitchen cabinets, instead of tearing them all out and getting new ones, a fresh coat of paint can do wonders. We did end up changing the cabinets in our kitchen, and I'll talk about the great deal we found on those and how to save money on that kind of thing. But if you aren't going to tear out cabinets and replace them, or you just want an updated look, think about paint. You can be really bold and unique. The island that we have in our kitchen is original. We did put a new countertop on it and got new baseboards around it, but I painted the drawers and cabinets blue, and I love that look, and it just made such a difference. So you can get creative and paint your cabinets a different color and just really update your space, and it really is inexpensive to paint your own cabinet. You can also paint light fixtures, so if the metal just doesn't work with your decor or is outdated, you can take it off, use a little spray paint, super quick fix. We recently painted the steps that are from our garage into our mudroom, and it had been on my list for a while. The paint was like worn off in the middle of the steps, but because we use those steps so often, we had to make sure that people weren't walking on it. So we finally did it. It wasn't that big of a deal. Didn't take that long and made such a difference. So think about things that you can paint. A fresh coat of paint on your baseboards makes such a difference. We ding our baseboards. Sometimes we hit them with a vacuum cleaner, or if it's just been a long time since they've been installed, a fresh coat of paint can make such a difference. And if you want to go the extra mile, updating your baseboards, getting taller ones or just new ones, doesn't cost all that much money. It is obviously work, but a fresh coat of paint can make such a difference and really liven up your space. Another thing that you can paint are your fireplace inserts. When we bought this home, I knew we wanted to change the fireplaces. They were outdated and just like these giant mantles and giant tile hearths. And so we did tear those out. The inserts were perfectly fine though. It's just that they were gold around the fireplace, and all of the hardware was brushed nickel, the light fixtures and everything, so it didn't go. It looked outdated, and so we used a high heat paint and just painted that instead of ripping out something that was perfectly good. You can also paint the handrails in your home. So if things are just looking dingy, and obviously we're touching our handrails a lot, or if it's outdated looking, like the wood, you can paint those and just really brighten up your space. My next tip is to change or add hardware throughout your home. Adding new hardware can really update your kitchen. It isn't very expensive and shouldn't take very long. We had no hardware in our bathroom, and it took me a while. We just actually put it on after living here for 3 years, and we just picked out something simple that wasn't very expensive, because eventually we are going to take out these cabinets, so they aren't going to be here forever. So I didn't want to invest in hardware that was a lot more expensive. Another thing that we did in this home was change out the door hinges. They were old looking, not the finish that we wanted, so we took the doors off the hinges. We had to anyway, because we redid all of the flooring throughout the home except for a few tile floors. And so we changed out the hardware and the hinges, and it made such a difference. You can also change the doorknobs throughout your home, a really quick and easy fix, or you can paint your front door that may be a little older instead of replacing it, and just replace the hardware on the door to give it an updated look. Another thing that you can change out in your home that makes a big difference is light switch covers and outlet covers. They aren't very expensive, but you can definitely update your space by changing those out. Craigslist for the win. We scored so many deals on Craigslist. And if you've been with me for a while, you know that we found our kitchen cabinets on Craigslist. Now you have to be careful and make sure they're actually going to work for your space and measure and really make sure it's going to work before you purchase them, because you know they probably were designed for someone else's kitchen and you can make them work, or someone might have all brand new cabinets. So definitely check Craigslist for things like cabinets, check for building materials, check for everything first before you spend extra money. So we bought our kitchen cabinets on Craigslist and we made sure that they were going to work. We had to purchase one new smaller cabinet just to make it work in our space. It's the one next to the kitchen sink, like a slimmer cabinet, so it wasn't horribly expensive. And then we had molding added to the top to finish it out. In that same lot of stuff that we purchased, we were able to get cabinets for the powder room and granite for the powder room. Now we did have to purchase our kitchen granite, pay more for that, but we did find granite on Craigslist and we were able to cut it to the size for our powder room, so it was a great find. We found a brand new kitchen sink that was a really nice kitchen sink on Craigslist for a lot cheaper. So sometimes people purchase things and they just don't work for their space or whatever. We were able to find our fireplace mantles on Craigslist and we just painted them and saved so much money by finding them on Craigslist. Next, I wanted to share some inexpensive updates that you can do to your home. We wanted to add a backsplash and we looked at a lot of tile and some of it is so incredibly expensive. And I really like the look of white subway tile and it's so inexpensive. So that is what we did and I love the look. It's a classic look. It's not going to go out of style in 5 years or anything. So just think about ways that you can add improvements to your home that don't cost tons of money. We have a larger master bathroom and to completely tear everything out would be very expensive. One day we will update it even more, but basically we just painted it, painted the cabinets, added hardware, and just clean the tile and then decorate it a little bit. And I love our master bathroom. It doesn't have to be all brand new. But one thing that really dated the space when we first purchased this home is glass block windows in the shower. And it just gave it a 90s look and I did not like them. So one of our friends had a good old time bashing those glass blocks out. And instead of replacing the entire shower, we just replaced that one window. We were already doing tons of renovations and we really didn't want to spend a lot in there. So that one piece made such a difference. It looks so much better than the glass block windows. I wanted to share a few things that you can do outdoors. So when we purchased our home, no one had lived here in a while, and before that it was a rental property and the outside really needed some work. We bought our house in the winter, so we didn't really know how neglected it was until everything started growing in the spring and there were weeds galore. And it did take a lot of time, but we just did it ourselves. And instead of ripping out all of the landscaping and everything, we just took out all the weeds, we trimmed back the bushes and trees, and we laid fresh mulch. Mulch can make a huge difference in how your overall outdoor space appears. It doesn't have to cost a ton. Just adding a fresh layer of mulch and pulling the weeds makes such a difference. Then you can get some inexpensive pots and plant some flowers, and it just really brightens up the space without spending tons of money. Just get creative, think outside of the box, and you can have a beautiful home that you love without spending an enormous amount of money. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Let me know what some of your favorite tips are. And if you aren't subscribed to my channel, I would love to have you subscribe. If you haven't already checked out Hillary's video, I will link it in the description box. Be sure to head over to her channel and tell her that Jen sent you. Thank you again for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day.